Hi, my name is Fredrik Samlom from the NX marketing team. In this short tips and tricks session, we are going to take a look at the performance predictor and the new additions introduced in NX 2406. The performance predictor simulation application in NX is a quick and easy tool that helps engineers to immediately, and still in the modeling environment, rapidly evaluate their designs and quickly get the design right from start. The tool helps engineers reduce the design and full validation iterations while saving precious time. If required, the analysis information defined using the Performance Predictor application can seamlessly be transferred to the full CAE tool. The improvements in the performance predictor introduced in NX 2406 are support for thermal analysis, which is exactly what it states, and publish, that uses templates and standardizes your report on the DOCX format. So, let's have a look at the performance predictor and the just introduced improvements to the application. We will look at the improvements to the performance predictor by using this cylinder block as a quick study case. Here we start from scratch and we will add some mechanical loads as well as temperature loads to demonstrate the new capabilities in performance predictor. We start by ensuring that the performance predictor toolbar and the performance predictor navigator are active, as these are required when creating and assessing the results of our analysis. With the performance predictor application active, we start by activating the delay option, as this will delay any update while defining the analysis criteria. We continue by creating a first analysis and name it quick check temp slash mech. In this case, we will be using the structural linear statics option, as we will be studying the thermal as well as the mechanical impact combined. We keep the resolution to coarse, as we want a really fast result, given that this is just a quick initial validation to indicate if we are on the right path with our design. You can of course set the resolution to finer. Just note that it will take a bit longer for the system to produce the result, as it will require more computational power. Now, with the first analysis we just created active, we can go ahead and add the constraints and conditions we want to validate our design against. As our model only contains one solid body, that is already defined in our analyze. Continuing, you can either add your constraints and conditions using the sequential menu setup to reach a fully defined solution, or you can use the items in the Performance Predictor Navigator by right mouse button select on the conditions folder and choose create. We start by adding the surrounding temperature as an environment load. As we assume that the surrounding temperature for this isolated analyze is comfortable 20 degrees Celsius, we type in 20 in the magnitude field and check that we have set the temperature to Celsius. Note that clicking on the temperature field allows for us to change to other temperature scales should we need. We move on to defining the analysis constraints. As the design is going to be exposed to both heat and mechanical load, we start by adding a mechanical fixed constraint where the cylinder head meets the crank case. Note that the quick pick is used here, where you simply hover the cursor over the area where you want the face selected. Use the scroll wheel to get to the desired face and use the left mouse button to select. This way, you don't need to move your cursor to the list and select from there. The area around the supercharger of the engine is kept at around 120 degrees Celsius. We select the area here defined by a group face feature. And so we can use the feature face as selection scope and enter the temperature 120 degrees Celsius. As this is a combustion engine and a V8 cylinder block, we know that we will have loads that needs to be taken into consideration. The mechanical load in this example is represented by the pressure that builds up in the cylinders. So, as a first analysis load, we will add about 350 psi as pressure acting on the cylinder walls. Here we also see the benefit of the Select Similar Faces tool that really helps us in identifying and multi-selecting all the internal cylinder walls. As a final load and to showcase the new ability in Performance Predictor to handle temperature, we also add a heat flux load to the cylinder walls. We again use the Select Similar Faces tool to easily multi-select all the inner cylinder walls. And set the heat flux to about 1000 watts per square meters. All the input criteria for our analyze is now defined and we can toggle off the delay option. Clicking the little red checkbox in the Performance Predictor Navigator updates the analyze. From now on, with no delay active, all potential changes to the criteria will immediately be calculated and presented. Note the speed of the analyze. It only takes a few seconds, and the first result we have on the screen is the displacement. We turn the peak values off as we want a clear view to the colors and the scale with the various values representing the results. By changing the result settings, we can change the result displaying to temperature. Under the temperature display, we can change the contour style to banded and the color style to spotlight, as this will really put attention to the critical areas. Now, with the analyze in place, let's have a look at the new reporting tool. Publish evokes the templated approach to create your reports in a standardized way. The report produced will be in the form of a .docs format and will be filled in according to your preference. The first tab on the report tool, Publish, lets you select what template to use and where you want the report located on your system. The second tab, Text, lets you add the text required for the analyze report in regard to the part. If in managed mode, this will be handled automatically for you. The third tab, Viewport, lets you tailor how you want the results presented. Here, for example, we want to replicate the analyze we have on the screen, so we modify the fourth row where we have the temperature result represented. We set the contour style to banded, and as we really want the critical area to stand out, we use the spotlight option for the color style. Executing the publishing of the analysis report collects all the constraints, environment loads, analysis loads, and all the results, and finally publishes them in the templated report. Scrolling through the report, we can see the analysis input criteria, the result of the displacement, the result of the stress analyze according to von Mises, the result of the factor of safety, and finally the result of the temperature. We note that the display of the temperature is not according to what we want, so we close the report and move back to NX and the Performance Predictor, where we start a new publish where we set the color style to spotlight. And then we reproduce the report and choose to overwrite the old one as we made an update. We note that the correct display of the temperature is now used in the report. To summarize what you have seen in this tips and tricks session of the new additions to the performance predictor in NX. In general, you have seen how to simply define a structural linear static analysis utilizing the already existing creation criteria. More focused on the new additions, you have seen how to add fixed temperature as an environment load. You have seen how to add a fixed temperature constraint to a phase region. You have seen how to add a load in the form of heat flux. In addition, you have seen how to generate a standardized and templated report using the new addition in the form of publish. This concludes this tips and trick session on the Performance Predictor tool, and I would like to humbly thank you for your time and attention.